Dream about four flying monkeys. Dream and interpretation. My dream, in short, I have seen a ziggurat-like ancient building in perfect condition, Babylon. On four of its top corners, four big, couple of meters tall, flying monkeys arrived to guard Babylon. They looked to the south, north, east, and west, each one four different directions. They had huge black wings. They were evil and dangerous, wanted to chase everybody who did leave the building. Explanation in short, people, churches and regimes who have a lot of secrecy are hiding behind thick walls, and they are against transparency. When the Lord opens your eyes and ears, you can see through thick walls and you can see the secrets. Fake churches and authoritarian regimes are known about control, and they are dangerous. If you want to leave them, they want to destroy you with lies and smear campaign. Fake churches can be Pentecostal, charismatic, or they belong to the Word of Faith movement. They want to control you. We need to escape anyway. Stepping outside of Babylon is dangerous, but we are safe in God's hand. Stepping outside can be hard because you will leave your comfort zone. You can also read the written version of my dream in my blog, the long version. When you have a dream from the Lord Almighty, it used to be very different from your usual dreams. I had this dream on the 16th of September 2019, around 4 a.m. European time. We, some people and I, went into a big building, which looked like a huge cube, except its sides became shorter on top, like pyramid mixed with ziggurat. Almost ziggurat, but it had smooth sides, no visible windows, no ornaments. It was a massive building, which looked perfect. There was not any fault on it, except it looked old, very, very old, looked ancient, had brownish and greenish colors, like an ancient building has. It was made with huge old bricks long, long time ago. Despite its age, it was in perfect condition, with no visible signs of destruction. This ancient-looking, enormous, cubish building had no ornaments, just articulated structure of construction. Some parts just stepped forward a little bit, some parts was behind a little bit. There was some structure how they placed the bricks, but on this ancient-looking building, I was not discovered any ornaments, sculptures, animal or flower forms, nothing. It had a strict and dark look. Despite it was a couple of thousand years old building, there wasn't any ruins. There wasn't any visible sign of new parts and renovation either. It was in top condition. I had never seen such a building in my life, not in the history books nor in movies. It was so huge and tall, massive and strong, no decay, no broken bricks, nothing. But it was in use. The ziggurat-like building had a huge wide gate, the only gate you can get inside. After you entered the gate, there was an inside yard with no roof, the sky was above you. It's supposed to be a big garden inside, but everything was dried. Even the lawn and the one or two tree with no leaves, these supposed to be green, but instead these were such a disappointment. Like in winter, but without any snow. It wasn't winter and everything was so dry. No proper garden, no fauna, no color. Even around the building, you cannot even see any greenery, just wilderness. When we entered into the inner backyard, I had a thought that I had to make a couple of photos about the outside look of the building and the inner courtyard before entering. Somehow, I didn't know I will not able to make photographs about these on the next day. Then I realized it is impossible to do anything about it because I have forgot about my camera. It was not with me. After we entered in the main gate into the inner courtyard, some people and I, around 10 or more, kept going to the left wing of this building. There was a huge room with high ceiling, about the height of the main building, with no windows on it. The room itself was used for some kind of education, and we were there for training. There was a huge wooden table somewhere at the edge of this enormous room, which looked so tiny compared with the hugeness of the classroom. Inside it looked like a historical castle room from the Dark Ages. The big, big rustical wooden table was surrounded by simple heavy and big wooden chairs. All of these furnitures looked handmade. There were not any ornaments on those. I had my old blue bag with me, which I used to use on weekdays, never on important events. I hanged my blue bag on one of those heavy wooden chairs. About 5 or 10 meters away, there was a group of people. I joined to them for some chat without carrying anything with me. There were so few people inside compared with the wideness of that huge room. There were every kind of people there, small children and adults. They must be friends or something, or a team I trusted, because I trusted them to leave my bag so far away from me on the chair. Suddenly, from the other wings of that building, I started to hear other people's voices with surprised reactions, with wows, lots of wowings. Despite all of the rooms in the building were without windows, we were able to see through the thick walls. They became transparent before our eyes. We just started to see what's going on in the inner courtyard. A huge hand appeared from above, about the size of a two-story building, and every one of us started to hear the next phrase from the Bible inside of our heart, like a pain before childbirth. And the first time, I thought it was a baby. During this time, the big, big hand of God reached out from above and picked up something which looked like a huge ball, but it was inside some shiny, bright, snow-white clothing material. The whole scene reminded me to a white dove holding a green olive branch. Then a huge hand with his white package disappeared from the inner yard. Without moving from the room, we started to hear that other people shouting again from the other wings. We were able to see it through the thick walls and the roof, which was not a real roof, just beams and bricks. It became transparent and we were able to see a terrible creature. It was flying down from the sky and landed on one corner of the top of the building. It was black with huge wings. It looked like a dark angel, except it was a huge monkey with wings. It had landed on one of the four top corners of the building. And the other, it appeared, landed on the other corner. A third appeared, then a fourth. Each of them landed. The last one landed on our side of the top corner of the building. From a distance, they looked like huge statues. They had ugly faces and they looked brutally evil. They became the guards of the building. They started to watch the surrounding area. Those huge flying monkeys, like dark angels or statues on the Notre Dame, started their watching. Inside of that building, a lot of us realized we are trapped. We are trapped inside. We are in danger. Once we are out, there'll be more danger waiting for us. And we felt we need to leave our classroom and never come back. The only property I had was my bag. We thought we need to escape from this building, and that will not be easy. The four big flying monkeys will be able to see us when we leave the building. Once we are out, we will be chased. Despite the dangers of these big creatures, we became brave. We knew that we need to escape from that building no matter how. During this time, there was a music in the background, like trumpet sounds, four of them, like movie music, long trumpet sounds for long minutes, not just seconds. At the end of the dream, when I suddenly woke up, there was a song, the dream, dream, dream song. So it was a dream. I had some interpretation. Your dream from the Lord has many layers. Maybe you will find out the new layers of meaning of your dream a couple of months or years later. I had some interpretation from the Lord. The building had some similarities with ancient ziggurats. Thousands of years ago, Mesopotamia had his own ziggurats. The ziggurats had shrine on their tops. This building in the dream had some shrine look. The ziggurat was an ancient building, an empire, which is still exists behind the scenes, Babylon. There is no ruins in Babylon. It is still going strong. Something new did born, and the hand of God took it away. It looked like a womb, packaged in white linen. And the good God took it away, like somebody stealing a treasure. He told in our hearts that all these are the beginning of birth pains. And the verse about pain of childbirth, Matthew 24, nation will rise against nation, the kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of birth pains. When you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, you will be hated by all the nations because of me. So the famine and earthquakes are the beginning of birth pain. These are the beginning of birth pain. The building represents the world, evil communist, socialist, and other regimes, and false churches. False church is all of the belief systems altogether, which are different from the God's perfect will. False church can be even Pentecostal, charismatic church, if they have corrupted leaders who are creating their own reality. With them, the ancient Babylon is still living and going strong. It's an evil empire. Everybody has to escape from Babylon, everybody who can see or hear the message. Everybody who is escaped will be hated, lied about, and chased. Babylon the Great is still in power. They will spy on you. They want to destroy you with lies and smear campaigns. These people can be some leaders from the Word of Faith movement or evil governments. The ziggurat had four flying monkeys, like dark angels with power. All of the four creatures were black with bigger wings. Their wings were transparent and a little bit. They are winged monkeys. In the psychology, when you escape from narcissists, sooner or later relatives or friends will appear who believe to the lies of your abuser and causing more damage. There are flying monkeys in everyday life as well. The timing of the dream. The dream itself must be on an average day, because I haven't my small camera with me, not even a mobile phone. Matthew 10. Do not get any gold or silver or copper to take with you in your belts. No bag for your journey, or extra shirt or sandals or stuff. For the worker is worth his keep. I'm sending you out like sheep among wolves. But when they arrest you, do not worry about what to say or how to say it. At the time you will be given what to say, for it will not be you speaking, but the spirit of your father speaking through you. Brother will betray brother to death, and the father his child. Children will rebel against their parents and have them put to death. You will be hated by everyone because of me, but the one who stands firm to the end will be saved. When you are persecuted in one place, flee to another. New kind of Christianity is coming. It will be different from how we do now. We have to follow Jesus' steps. During the dream, there was a music in the background, like trumpet sounds, four of them, like a music. Long trumpet sounds, for long minutes, not just for seconds. At the end of the dream, and after I woke up, another catchy song started. Dream, 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 dream. I need you, that I could die. I love you so, and that is why, whenever I want you, all I have to do is dream, 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 dream. Like the building of Babylon, fake churches are looking inside, and they are like prisons. They want to check every information. Fake churches are perfect for baby Christians. In the courtyard, everything was dry. Trees can be seen without fruits and leaves. In fake churches, everything is dry, no fruits, no colors, no life. They are looking inside as if they want to hide something behind the walls. There is a lot of secrecy in fake churches. You are not allowed to talk, telling the truth. You are under control. Please pray about the people in China. Like in China, in fake churches, you need to obey and keep silence when oppressed. If you are telling the truth about fake churches, or in China about CCP, you will be in trouble. They want to spy on you, they send the flying monkeys, they want to destroy you. Even you are in the greatest trouble, people in China have more trouble. If somebody telling the truth in China ends up in prison or their organs harvested and die. China's ruling system based on lies. People in China are suffocating because they are not free. They used as tools, not humans. The whole world is suffocating right now because the dragon virus from China CCP suffocates them. Corona means crown. Stars and celebrities who are so desperate to get your attention lost their crowns because of an evil virus. This controlling virus shouldn't rule the world. Fast and pray as long as you can, and we will win over the coronavirus. Please pray for the people of China. Pray for the people who are living in any regimes, who are poor and oppressed. Be brave. You need to leave the fake churches. If you want to escape, you are in God's hand, and the flying monkeys are not able to destroy you. Stepping outside to the unknown wilderness seems to be dangerous, but we are in God's hand. Be brave to dream, and be brave to tell the world. People, churches, and regimes who have a lot of secrecy are hiding behind thick walls, and they are against transparency. When the Lord opens your eyes and ears, you can see through thick walls, and you can see the secrets. Fake churches and authoritarian regimes are known about control, and they are dangerous. If you want to leave them, they want to destroy you with lies and smear campaign. Fake churches can be Pentecostal, charismatic, or they belong to the Word of Faith movement. They want to control you. We need to escape anyway. Stepping outside of Babylon is dangerous, but we are safe in God's hand. Stepping outside can be hard, because you will leave your comfort zone, but you will be fine if you repent. You need to see things differently. Follow Jesus. Following Jesus is not easy. Comes with persecution, problems. But many problems the righteous has, all of them will be solved by the Lord.